Behind the Lines in 3, 2, 1, go!
And we're underway, 15 seconds on the clock as we tick down through the autonomous period. Again, all the drive crews can do is stand back and watch, relying completely on their coding. 41-45 for the Red Alliance comes up and over the charge station. Period comes to a close. Unofficially, your score 21-15. Adjustment to the score now 15-13. It'll be the Red Alliance with a 2-point advantage. Drive teams now in full control. Watching now is 41-45, jets all the way across the field into the Red Alliance loading zone. Human player there at the single substation, attempting to load a cone onto the robot. In the meantime, for the Blue Alliance, 2095, working to deliver a cube to one of the lower nodes. Near side referee indicating a foul. That foul will be on the Red Alliance. Find out what that is all about here at the end of the match. 41-45 for Red, reaching up high. Remote manipulator system is engaged, trying to deliver a cone. That cone ends up falling all the way down to the bottom of the grid. No joy there. 29-20, Blue Alliance with a 9-point advantage as we reach the 1-minute mark. .82-43 on the move for the Blue Alliance. In its possession, one of the game pieces, this one a cone, as they look for a place to put it. 42 seconds remain. Now the Astro Circuits lose their grip on their cone. They have to chase down another one. 30 seconds. We're in the end game. Red Alliance taking the offensive. They're down by one, but charging hard. It's all gonna come down to their in-game performance. Both alliances have 2 robots each at their charge stations. 8 seconds left. Red Alliance trying to get 3 robots on the charge station. As time expires, Red Alliance will have 1 robot docked. Blue Alliance. Blue Alliance wins the closest match of this tournament, 45-44. Coming up next, qualifying match number 80.